Now, what is racial identity these days? In the United States, viewers have been stunned by the story of a prominent civil rights activist who says she is African-American. But a couple claiming to be her parents say she is actually white. Rachel Dolezal says she has been the victim of a number of hate crimes. Regina Vaidyanathan has more from Washington.
Rachel Dolezal is a race relations campaigner. As a regional president of the NAACP, she's a face for the group which represents African Americans. A professor in African studies, she lists herself as black on official documents. Except she isn't. Rachel looked like this when she was younger. Local reporters smelled a rat and confronted her about her family.
I don't understand the question of, I did tell you that, yes, that's my dad. And he was unable to come in January.
Are your parents, are they white?
By her dad, she meant this man. He's not. This is Rachel with her biological parents on her wedding day 15 years ago. Her ex-husband is black.
Our daughter is primarily German and Czech and of European descent.
So she's white.
Caucasian. She's white.
Mm-hmm. So what I say to them is, you know, I don't give two what you guys think.
The president of the NAACP, who we think is a black woman who says she's the victim of hate crimes, might not be black. That seems like a misrepresentation.
I can understand that. I mean, like I said, it's more important for me to clarify that with the black community and with my executive board than it really is to explain it to a community that I quite frankly don't think, you know, really understands.
Authorities are investigating whether Rachel Dolezal broke any rules by claiming she was black. Her stories fascinated America at a time when the issue of race is at the top of the agenda. Regina Vaidyanathan, BBC News, Washington.
Well, let's speak to Marcia Dawkins, an author and communication professor at the University of Southern California, also a commentator with the Huffington Post Black Voices website. I mean, it is bizarre. I mean, it seems to raise far more questions than answers. What do you make of it?
I make of it what she herself has said. I don't understand the question and I don't understand her answers. It's a very bizarre situation, but one that has a long history when we think about racial passing in the United States.
Well, yeah,
she's not the first person.
Yeah, exactly. I mean, on that point, passing has happened a lot, but hasn't it traditionally been blacks passing as whites? Is it rarer the other way around?
It certainly is rarer, but it has happened, and it has happened throughout history. People passing as black in order to investigate civil rights issues. I mean, we have very famous books written about these types of things during the civil rights era, although they're extremely problematic, right? For exactly the reason that we see here today with this public outing.
Why do we think that her parents, I mean, is there any doubt that these are her natural parents, have outed her?
I don't know what to make of that either, which is a humongously dramatic thing here, right? We've got this family issue going on. There's obviously a very complex layer here that needs to be uncovered. And one of the rules in my research that I've done about passing is that you never out a passer because you could, in fact, put their life in danger. You could put their psyche in danger. So why they would come out this way is very interesting to me, especially given where they all come from in Idaho, which is a very racist location.
And the fact that she originally married a black guy, I mean, that obviously has a huge importance in this story. What is the black community saying about it?
Well, if we go on Twitter, for instance, we see a host of opinions, everything from we're confused, we don't understand, to is this minstrelsy, you know, she should be fired, and anything in between, to questions of how did she get that wonderful hairdo with all that volume, right? So people really, really are intrigued and want to know why she would do this. And while it would be easy to demonize her, the point is she was trying to do what many consider the right thing in terms of fighting for civil rights and civil justice. So the larger question that people are asking now is, why did she feel she couldn't do this as a white person? Why did she have to feel that she had to have the profile of a person of color in order to speak out against racism and violence?
Okay, just very briefly.
That's pretty interesting.
Yeah, I mean, it is interesting, but very briefly. I mean, is this playing on all the nets at the moment? Is this the big story of the day?
this is the story of the day. This is all anybody's talking about. And if we think about what do we do from here, everybody's equally confused as well, because we've never had this kind of public conversation about it before.
All right. Okay. Good to speak to you, Marcia Dawkins. Thank you very much indeed for joining us on the program. Stay with us. Still to come.